This is a different setup than I usually have, so hopefully nothing gets bumped or knocked or whatever. So you can see what's going on. I'm gonna put the parts placement up there for now. I'm gonna get rid of that in a few seconds.
Thank you.
just have a pile of my spent component legs, but I recently repurposed a box that my LDRs came in to hold all my resistor legs temporarily until I'm able to dump them. It's helped clean up my work area. starting to get crowded on here, so I'm gonna solder these. Sometimes with the vertical resistors, I'll go ahead and solder the part that I can on the top, and then flip it over and do the rest, but I'm just gonna do it all from the bottom. Thank you. looks like we're about 43 minutes in. Gonna try to finish this up here, hopefully within the hour. Electrolytic capacitors, I think they pick 47. Kits that needed, I used to just buy the 10 microfarad ones from Tata in bulk, but I had a few kits that needed the low profile ones, so I got a ton of those from Mouser or DigiKey, actually both now, and that's just all I use now, unless I get a kit like this that has taller ones. Much more expensive and they fit in a lot more places. So for those that haven't read through the wavefolder project, it uses transistors for the wavefolding, and then an op amp for some amplification and buffering. So there are two. Two different transistor types, because there's NPN and what is it, PNP? Not an electrical engineer like Isaac. And the last one should be a 547. should note there's a note in the box because the 548s that are specified in the schematic are actually 547 is in the box. Transistors, I usually like to rotate through them so I'm not heating one up for too long as I'm doing all the legs. Thank you. All right, we're getting there. Hi, Shmuel. I missed the film capacitors at some point. Oh, no, that's next. Perfect. Alright, there are two film capacitors, and then there's a trimmer pot, multi-turn trimmer pot. Is 2 and 2. Big one here. Parts left. All right, the power header is keyed, and it says -12 volts goes over here. It has a little notch in the corner. There's no notch in the corner of the keyed header, but there's an arrow there, and I know that that's where -12 volts goes. The key is facing up, or actually, I guess it goes this way, so it's facing down. It does show the key on the guide. Thank you. fits all the parts. Now we're just putting the pot and the jacks on. And he says to insert the jacks and solder them and then line the pot up before you solder it, but I like to line everything up for both with the panel. So I'm just putting my jacks in, gonna squeeze the pot a little, fit the retention clips, put that in. Top nut, bottom nut on. And then check to make sure the pot can turn freely. I'm gonna put my board upside down in my open hands. I put some heat shrink on the end of my helping hands. Saw some of the ones you could order have that, and I was like, oh, that's a great idea, so it doesn't mark up everything. So I stole it. Put the bottom jack through the wrong ground. Oh, yep, I tried to put it through one of the test points. Glad I caught that. Would have been a confusing thing to troubleshoot. That's it then. I'm just gonna take a look at the back here and make sure none of the vertical resistors are running into each other. Okay. And transistors are facing each other. Okay, I just need to put the TL-074 chip. And my little chip leg thing here makes it nice and straight to pop them in. Check it out. Unfortunately, it doesn't have any lights on it to let us know if it's working, so we'll have to put some things through it. oscilloscope here. watching.